Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 brings with it a lot of new privacy and security features to help you really keep your information private to you. But there are three other ways you can actually lock it down a little bit further to help keep your location secret to only you. So I wanted to share with you three different ways that you can do that. And the first thing you need to know is Apple has actually added a security feature so that the first time you install an application that requests your location, it will prompt you. So we'll open this application and you'll see it says, do I want to allow WeatherBug to access your location? Now, I may not want to allow this. I may only want to allow it once or allow while using the app. And if I allow it to use it while using the app, it will locate me and then provide me with my weather information. So that's okay with me, but I want it to go away and stop sharing my information as soon as I close the app. The first time you open an app, you cannot allow it to always track your location. So that's a new feature to lock it down. However, there's some features we can customize specifically individually to really lock the phone down. So if we go into settings and then scroll down to privacy, we have location services at the top. That's actually nothing new. However, there are some new features within this. So with location services, we can turn it off altogether, but this really poses a problem when it comes to using things like navigation with the Maps application or Google Maps or whatever you use, because if you have this turned off altogether, it can't use your location, so it's really not doing you a service. Now you could turn this on and off every time, but it's easier just to turn it on and then customize it as needed. So if we scroll down to things like maps, we can go in and tell it to never use our location, ask next time, or use it or while using the app. So I would recommend a map application setting it to while using the app. It will only use your location while you're using it. Now, if you have an application that's using it all the time, there's a new privacy alert that I would recommend keeping on all the time, and that is show map in location alerts. So maybe you have an application that's using your location information always. You've set it to always, you've allowed this. Well, there's a new feature where this pops up and tells you you're allowing it once in a while. It will pop up every so often and show you based on a map where it's actually been locating you. So you can either disable it or continue to use it, as you can see here on the left. And I had my Tesla app set to always. So instead of always, I switched it to while using the app. And it's just a nice way to lock it down even further. Now, if you'd like to see which apps are using your location information regularly, you have a couple indicators here as well. You have a purple arrow, a gray arrow, and you also have a hollow purple arrow, which means a little bit different. Now, a purple arrow lets you know that your application has recently used your location. A hollow arrow will let you know that it's been used under certain circumstances, and then a gray arrow lets you know that it's been used within the past 24 hours. So you can really customize this based on that information. For example, Facebook, I would never allow Facebook to use my information as far as location is concerned. They don't really need to know that, so I've got it set to never. I have that set to never for a couple different applications. For example, Twitter really doesn't need to know my location, so I'll turn that off. So that's one way you can lock this down. Now, the second method for stopping tracking on your phone has to do with when you're on the internet and using Wi-Fi. Now, maybe you're traveling or you're at a coffee shop working and on public Wi-Fi networks. It's really a good idea to lock that down. And that's where today's sponsor comes in, Surfshark. Surfshark has sponsored this video. However, I use Surfshark all the time when I'm on public networks. So if we go into Surfshark, we'll open it up and hit Quick Connect. This will connect us with a VPN locally. And what this does is create a secure tunnel between me and whatever I'm doing. Now, Surfshark does not keep a record of your logs or anything like that, and that's why I use them. They're very serious about their privacy. And also, you can hide your location using this because it's not showing them your real IP address. If we go to locations, you can also make it look like you're in a different country. So maybe you're traveling abroad and you want to use the United States so you can watch Netflix, watch your different shows that are only available in the United States. You can make it look like you're in the United States. Maybe you're in the United States and you want to make it look like you're in Japan. You can do that as well. There's also a feature for clean web. This stops more tracking as far as ads, trackers, malware, and phishing attempts. And then thirdly, there's a great feature that actually disconnects your internet connection should the VPN drop. So it really locks everything down. And And this VPN is very fast. I've had no issues with it. You saw how quickly it connected, and I use it all the time. Now, if you want to try it out for yourself, you can just go to surfshark.com/zollotech and enter the promo code zollotech for 83% off and 1 month free. And it's definitely worth checking out. Just download the app, check it out, see what you think. And I highly recommend using it. When it's active, you'll see VPN here in the top. Now, aside from using a VPN, there's actually a third way that people can use your location information other than Wi-Fi, and that has to do with Bluetooth. So if, again, we go into our privacy settings, and that's under settings, privacy, and then Bluetooth, applications can actually triangulate your position using Bluetooth. And I would highly recommend you turn it off for applications such as Facebook. Again, there's no reason Facebook needs to use my location, nor does some of these other applications. So I turn that off, such as Amazon. There's no reason Amazon needs to use Bluetooth for me. I'm not using wireless headphones with it, and I'm not using it to control anything like a drone like I have here with DJI Go. So really make sure this is customized and locked down to what you're using it for. Rove Motion is a slider I use that uses Bluetooth, so I know that I need Bluetooth. The same goes with Tesla. It's the key to use the phone and connect to play music, so I need Bluetooth. So just keep that in mind and adjust this according to what you need. And that's really it. Those three things will really lock down your location information. However, there's a fourth thing that you really have no control over, and that is your cellular carrier, unless you put your phone into airplane mode. So your cellular carrier actually has your location information because it can triangulate it based off the actual cell tower. So there's no way to hide it from your actual carrier that way. The best bet there is to use a VPN as far as your traffic is concerned. However, you can't unless you're in airplane mode, because they'll be able to triangulate your location based off of your signal strength to local towers. That's it for locking down your information. If you'd like to try out Surfshark, like I mentioned, go to surfshark.com/zollotech and enter the promo code zollotech. Thanks again for sponsoring this video. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.